In the best of times, food insecurity is an often hidden crisis. For many of us, there's no question about serving something delicious for our next meal. And our main question about food is, what should we have for dinner? I'm Steve Frank. It's early in the morning when the first volunteers arrive to begin sorting, giving out, and delivering food from the pantry at Rumpel Memorial Presbyterian Church, Blowing Rock Cares Food Pantry. Board member and volunteer Tim Harris said that often hidden away from us are a large number of households who have been in need of food help for some time. And because of that need, High Country Food Banks have worked hard for years to meet the needs, doing a truly remarkable job. Tim Harris.
Why do we have food pantries, food bank? When you take 55, almost 56,000 people, residents in the county, and do the math with that overall poverty rate, you get between 15,500 and 16,000 people in the county who are living at or below the poverty level.
Diane Miller of Casting Bread knows the need all too well.
Started out as a client of Casting Bread. I was really sick. They told me that I wasn't going to live, and Casting Bread came out here and they fed my family. They gave me gas vouchers to get back and forth to the doctor, and I promised God that if I was healed, I would give back, and I've been giving back for going on 12 years now.
But when COVID-19 hit, the issue of food insecurity ramped up many times over as jobs were put on hold or were lost entirely. Schools closed, and unseen by many of us, school-supplied meals were impacted. Watauga schools ramped up meal delivery, even internet delivery via school buses. But at the same time, grocery shelves became void of staples we regularly serve. And there were real questions, real fears about what might happen next. Food pantries found themselves stepping in and ramping up, according to Rumpel Memorial Presbyterian Parish Associate Stephanie Hankins, who found her role suddenly changed.
And we were all talking about what we might do in response to knowing that there would be children at home who are used to eating at least two meals a day at school and getting snacks from school, and what they might do once they were home if they in fact closed school, which of course they did just a few days later.
We went from 25 boxes a week or 30 boxes a week to 200 boxes a week. And at that point, all the shelves were getting emptied.
The things that you couldn't find in the grocery store, we obviously couldn't find either. And then I would come in some weeks and think, how are we going to get enough boxes to have 200 boxes of food go out this week? But it always seemed to happen.
As soon as we started doing the boxes for the schools and churches around the county, that's when everything, I was basically going 6 or 7 days a week to all these different stores and purchasing whatever they had in stock.
The social workers at the different schools have identified families that they know have either lost their jobs, maybe have a single parent, have transportation issues. There's a host of things in our county that can keep people from having access to food.
The number of folks that are new to Casting Bread has increased every week since the middle of March. We broke some of, not records that you necessarily want to break, but the highest number of people that have come through at a certain time, or the most food that we've given out in a certain week, we're at the top, or we've broken the record of what our historic numbers have ever been. The common denominator is the fear of the unknown.
With new social distancing rules and limits on gathering, the way food banks had operated changed. Sam Garrett.
And hearing their stories, hearing how appreciative people are, and just hearing how life circumstance brought them to the point of need is it touches your heart. And now, this crazy time of COVID, we're meeting more and more new people.
I see homeless people. We have quite a few homeless that are living in their cars or living in a tent. I see young mothers that are single moms and have children to take care of, and they are unemployed now, not having enough food to feed their kids. And this has been going on since March, really bad, really bad.
And the restaurant community here, the new public house, was doing free breakfast for any kid under 18. And that kind of response was evident in the funds that were donated and the food that was donated. The business community, but particularly the food part of it, has done a lot to help these efforts in getting food out to people.
Had a friend at Renwood Mills who found out what we were doing, and they donated a lot of cornmeal and cornmeal mixes to us so that we could keep packing boxes with that kind of type, that kind of stuff.
I've been impressed by that community stepping forward, church after church after church, addressing hunger and homelessness.
Michael Brown, minister during summers at Blowing Rock Methodist Church.
And our folks, whose primary residence isn't there, feel that. Not only am impressed by that, I'm sometimes almost in awe of the fact that our people will say we're only here 4 months a year, but we know that human need is here 12 months a year. And we want to contribute in such fashion that when we're gone, our impact remains.
It's been a community effort. It's just not been one or two people. It's been, this church has been amazing about what they've done here.
I have been where they have been. I see them wearing sunglasses with tears rolling down their cheeks. To where they actually, they feel bad. And I tell them, this is not a handout, this is a hand up.
So I'm impressed. I love our church and its commitment, but I think it reflects that whole community.
If you have need, we will provide food for you. Now, we're part of the Second Harvest Food Bank Network, which means we keep track and we have interview questions, but we're here to serve. So. If somebody comes and presents themselves in a position of need, we provide food for them.
But the struggle is ongoing, and you can help by contacting the food pantry in your area or Blowing Rock Cares Food Pantry at Rumpel Memorial Presbyterian Church or Casting Bread at Faith Bridge Methodist on Aho Road.